Welcome back. Now, in less than 60 hours from now, Delhi goes to vote in the Lok Sabha elections amid an unprecedented heat wave that has seen the mercury levels touch the 47-degree mark, and also amid a burgeoning water crisis that seems to be bringing the city to its knees. For the past several days, residents of several parts of Delhi have been complaining of truncated and irregular water supply, not to mention a poor quality of water. The worst affected areas are, as you can see on your screens, Kamla Nagar, Karol Bagh, Pahadganj, New Rajinder Nagar, Baljit Nagar, Govindpuri, Tughlakabad, Punjabi Bagh and Moolchand. The culprit seems to be the depleting Yamuna water supply. Look at the situation, for instance, at the Wazirabad facility of the Delhi Jal Board. The targeted production of the Wazirabad plant is 134 million gallons a day. However, the facility supplied only 125.52 MGD on Monday and 122.4 MGD on Tuesday. In general, the normal level of pondage area in the Wazirabad plant is considered to be 674.5 feet. That has dropped to less than 672 on the 15th of May and less than 671 a week later. My colleague Nikhil now qualifies the numbers of the water scarcity in Delhi through this ground report.
Temperature rising across the part of the capital city. There is water scarcity which has also come to light like it usually is reported in every year. Currently, we are reporting from the South Delhi constituency. This is the Kusumpur Pahadi in the Vasant Vihar area. And this is the situation that we would like to show you on the visuals in the Mirror Now screen. You can see that these are the water cans which have been put up here by the people. And all of these are the cans for the water. And we have spoken to the locals as well. They are saying that usually at the summer time, the water tanker comes from the side of the authorities, but it goes insufficient. This is the story which is reported for every year. But nothing concrete has been done so far from the side of the authorities. But imagine the picture which is coming in from this particular side. You can see that on both sides of the roads, these are multiple cans which has been put up by the people, and these are the locals who have to suffer through this each and every year. Sare hi gharon ka ye haal hai kya yahan pe?
यहाँ पे तो लाखों झुग्गियाँ हैं, सबके साथ यही है। जिनकी रोडों पे झुग्गियाँ है ना, वहाँ पे रोड वालों को तो फायदा है यहाँ पे, क्योंकि उनके घर के आगे टैंकर उतरते हैं। लेकिन जो हमारे बीच का एरिया ना, ऊपर का एरिया, यहाँ पे ज्यादा दिक्कत है पानी की। यहाँ पे हमारे को ना पाइपलाइन चाहिए,
बहुत दिक्कत होती है यहाँ पानी के लिए।
सरकारों ने कुछ नहीं किया,
कुछ नहीं किया यहाँ, कुछ भी नहीं किया।
जब वोट आते हैं ना, इलेक्शन आ गए, अब सरकार आएगी यहाँ पे, फिर इसके बाद कोई नहीं आएगा 25 के बाद।
For citizens of Delhi, it's obviously a double whammy, dealing with power cuts caused by the sweltering heat as well as shortage of water. But if they were expecting words of assurance and hope from their leaders, they were sadly mistaken. As is always the norm, the Aam Aadmi Party and the BJP have waged a war of words over the water crisis in the city. Delhi's Jal Minister Atishi has alleged that BJP has hatched a new conspiracy to target the Aam Aadmi Party and through its Haryana government had stopped water supply. Listen in to her statement and the BJP's reaction.
भारतीय जनता पार्टी ने अपनी हरियाणा सरकार के माध्यम से दिल्ली के पानी को रोक लिया है। वो दिल्ली वालों को परेशान करने के लिए, दिल्ली में पानी की त्राही त्राही मचाने के लिए, दिल्ली में आ रही यमुना की वाटर सप्लाई को रोक रहे हैं। पिछले कुछ दिनों से जब जगह जगह से पानी की शिकायतें आनी शुरू हुई, जहां पे कभी पानी की शिकायत नहीं आती है, उसकी जांच करने पे पता चला कि यमुना का पानी हरियाणा सरकार द्वारा रोका जा रहा है।
सच्चाई ये है कि दिल्ली को पानी देना, नल से जल देना, बुजुर्गों का पेंशन देना, छोटी छोटी सड़कों का निर्माण करना, ये सारा दिल्ली सरकार का काम होता है। और इन सब में आज जो दिल्ली रो रही है, तो अगर उन्हीं के कैंडिडेट ने कह दिया कि पानी नहीं मिल रहा है, तो अब आज दिल्ली की जनता उस कैंडिडेट को भी बताएगी और आम आदमी पार्टी का जो शीर्ष नेतृत्व है उनको भी पता चलेगा। क्योंकि आम आदमी पार्टी में बहुत सारे ऐसे लोग हैं जिनके दिल में देश धड़कता है, और वो लोग इस समय वैसे ही उनका मन बदल चुका है जैसा अनिल झाजी ने कहा।
Quickly going across to my guest joining me, Dr. Dharinder Tayal from the BJP, Sanjeev Kaushik, political analyst, and also Umesh Sehgal, former Delhi chief secretary. Sanjeev Kaushik ji, coming to you first. Ye Delhi mein hokar sir, jabhi bhi kuch problem hota hai, whether it be pollution, jab par bijli katauti ki ho ya pani ka ho, सबसे पहले आम आदमी पार्टी के दिमाग में ब्लेम गेम क्यों आ जाते कि बीजेपी ने ये करवाया, बीजेपी ने वो करवाया। एज अ कॉमन सिटीजन वन आस्क्स, फिर दिल्ली की सरकार क्या करे अगर सब कुछ के वजह से दूसरे राज्य की सरकारों पर या केंद्र सरकार के ऊपर निर्भर करते हैं?
दिल्ली की सरकार क्या करेगी रितांशु, क्या जमुना में वजीराबाद में जमुना का जो जलस्तर है उसे बढ़ा देगी क्या? सब जानते हैं कि हरियाणा सरकार या हरियाणा से जो पानी आती है उसके आधार पर दिल्ली में पानी की सप्लाई होती है। इतिहास में, दिल्ली के इतिहास में कभी इस लेवल पे पानी नहीं पहुंचा। 640 फीट चलने वाला पानी लगातार आज की स्थिति जो है वो सबसे निचले स्तर पर है। और जो निचले स्तर पे पानी की स्थिति है, ये कहने में कोई गुरेज नहीं है कि पानी का जो लेवल सबसे निचले स्तर पे है तो सप्लाई निश्चित तौर पे वो बाधित होना ही होना है। और सप्लाई जब बाधित होगी तो लोग परेशान होंगे ही होंगे। हम तो सिर्फ ये कह रहे हैं कि क्या दिल्ली की सरकार को अपदस्थ करने के लिए या दिल्ली सरकार को परेशान करने के लिए इस लेवल तक की राजनीति की जा सकती है क्या? दिल्ली के जलमंत्री आतिशी जी ने आंकड़ों के साथ कहा कि 674 फुट हमेशा रहने वाला
670.9
फीट पानी हो गया।
Dr. Dharinder Tayal, the facts though are for the world to see. Yamuna water level has come down and has come down dramatically. That evidently means that the water supply has come down, and the water supply comes from Haryana. So where exactly is this conspiracy? I mean, where exactly is the merit in this blame game accusation which the BJP claims Aam Aadmi Party is doing?
Prithanshu, the fact of the matter is it is not a very discretionary sort of a thing that I can suddenly stop supplying the water, right? There is 1049 cusec which is mandated in the agreement which has to be given by Haryana, and over period repeatedly in various courts Haryana has been maintaining and courts have been accepting that Haryana has been giving the share of water to Delhi which it was supposed to give. How it is managing that water is something that the Delhi is answerable for. The other thing is that perpetually it has been that Aam Aadmi Party is never to be blamed for anything. In fact, the statement which Atishi has given, she has even blamed Swati Maliwal on BJP. Your founder member does something in the CM residence, you beat her up, and then you say, and you wipe out the CCTVs, and then you say BJP is to be blamed. Now, also, let's understand, sticking to the water thing, also, the reports are very clear that yes, even the power supply you've not been able to manage. For example, I have the data for Haidarpur. For the production, sufficient power could not be given, so the production has dropped by 7 to 8%. Now, did the Haryana government stop the power also? The problem area primarily is gross mismanagement right across, all over the place. And so when the water is drawn, I mean, you're not able to supply because you're not able to give the power to the plant. Now, this is exactly what Mr. Sachdeva has also asked, that when Mr. Kejriwal wrote a letter to you 1 month ago, everybody, all of us prepare, we know what is coming. He wrote a letter to you one month ago that, okay, prepare for a water crisis. What did you do? Atishi doesn't have any response to what action has been taken. Also, the responsibility is of the Delhi Jal Board. Now, Delhi Jal Board has been driven into the ground. At some time, they said, we're not getting money. They got about 76,000 crores. Over a period of time, from the central listing, they've got about 29,172 crores. But when the CAG visits them, they have maintained, and in court, this is in court, they have said, there is no accountability in the Delhi Jal Board. They did not even have a balance sheet so that the audit could be done. That is the state of affairs. So when there is such gross mismanagement, then to try that just before the elections, I will blame somebody else for everything, including, for example, remember oxygen? They said, I mean, center has not given us oxygen. How many people died in Delhi? And at that time also, ultimately, when the
Supreme Court ordered... Dr. Dharinder Tayal, I think the most I think the most obvious glaring example, Satish Kaushik ji, and I'll come to Umesh Sehgal shortly, but Sanjeev Kaushik ji, I beg your pardon. The most glaring example was air pollution, stubble burning. For years, Mr. Kejriwal claimed that stubble burning was happening due to Punjab not acting. Now, when an Aam Aadmi Party came to power in Punjab, in the last few years, there was still no change in the air quality of the national capital. But yet now, the blame doesn't come on the Punjab government.
तो दिल्ली की जनता पानी के लिए त्राही माम कर रही है और भाई साहब खुद स्वाति मालीवाल की पड़ी है उस पॉल्यूशन की भी बात करेंगे स्वाति मालीवाल
संजीव कौशिक जी बस दिल्ली की जनता नहीं है गुड़गांव में भी वही चीज हो रहा है गुड़गांव तो हरियाणा के अंदर आता है पानी का क्राइसिस हर जगह पर है बट गुड़गांव की सरकार गुड़गांव के प्रशासन किसी और को ब्लेम नहीं कर रही है
मैं सिर्फ ये कह रहा हूँ कि ये इस क्या क्या इस किस क्या इस कारण को नोटिस में लेने लायक नहीं है यह कारण कि पानी का लेवल नीचे क्यों गिरा है इतना क्या इसके बारे में दो शब्द नहीं है क्या इसके बारे में हरियाणा सरकार नहीं बोलेगी हरियाणा सरकार को चिट्ठी लिखेगी दिल्ली सरकार यदि वो सुनवाई नहीं करेगी तो दिल्ली सरकार करेगी किस मामले को लेकर हम कोर्ट तक जाएंगे सुप्रीम कोर्ट जाने की बात कर रही है सवाल यह है कि जिस पानी के लेवल को नीचे किया गया है रोका गया है उसके बारे में बात करें ना हम तमाम मुद्दों पर बात कर रहे हैं लेकिन मेन मुद्दों पर बात नहीं कर रहे हम मुझे पता है कि ये कोई परेशानी के कारण बात भी नहीं है वो तीन दिन की बात है केवल 25 तारीख बीत जाने दीजिए वोट हो जाए ये सारी कवायद ये है कि दिल्ली की जनता को परेशान किया जाए दिल्ली की जनता के नज़रों में केजरीवाल साहब को एक ये सिद्ध किया जाए कि ये सक्षम नहीं है अरे भाई साहब दिल्ली की जनता ने ही लगातार केजरीवाल साहब को जिताया और केजरीवाल साहब के नाम पे मुहर लगाया है और इस बार भी जिस तरह से दिल्ली की जनता को प्रताड़ित करने का प्रयास भारतीय जनता पार्टी कर रही है इस बार दिल्ली की जनता ही जवाब देगी इन सातों सीटों पर आप देखेंगे
Let me bring in Umesh Sehgal at this point. Sir, as a former Chief Secretary of Delhi, I must ask as a Delhiite and on behalf of the Delhiites who are watching also today, is this a fate that we have to suffer the curse of being a landlocked city which is not a full state but yet has to deal with the responsibilities of being one and for everything, whether it be land, whether it be agriculture, whether it be power supply, whether it be water, whether it be air pollution, our leaders will continuously bicker with each other and blame everything from the central government to other states or themselves and vice versa?
I cannot comment on the political aspects of the case, but in this particular case, I may mention that in 1996, if I remember the date or something around that date, there was a Supreme Court order which laid down that so many MGDs of water must be supplied to Delhi under any circumstances because drinking water must take precedence over irrigation requirements in Haryana. So that is an order which exists even now. Now what has happened in the last one or two days from what I read in the newspaper that there was a certain power failure, 2 or 3 hours in both the points where there is said to be water. The levels may have dropped because of that power failure. I mean, I'm not in a position to comment on that. But it is not the levels which the Haryana government is supposed to maintain. That level is supposed to be maintained by the Delhi Jal Board. The Haryana government has to release a certain amount of water every day for Delhi. I think it is 478 MGD or something around that. I'm not 100% sure. But there is a figure. And the Supreme Court has said that they will take a serious view if there is any shortfall in that. So the officers of the government which control the supply to Delhi and Haryana must be very much aware of the Supreme Court order. And I doubt very much if any engineer or officer serving in the government will deliberately defy any of those orders. But if they have defied, I think Delhi government would be quite justified in moving the Supreme Court and asking them to take action. But the Delhi government should be very sure that the fault is at the other end and not at their end. If there is a power failure for a couple of hours and power is not restored in a reasonable time, then who is responsible? And you can't put the responsibility on the Haryana government on that. So I think it should be washed for a couple of days. And if this continues, if they do not get that amount of water, just saying that level has dropped is a Delhi government responsibility. Level is not a Haryana government responsibility. Releasing a certain amount of water is Haryana government or Haryana officers' responsibility. I think that's very important, and that is where the figures will count, will mention. And if I doubt very much if the Haryana officers will allow this, and if it does fall, I'm sure they would request the government to move the Supreme Court and tell them that for the following reason, this has happened. Now there is another thing that if you blame Haryana, you can easily ask Punjab to give you an extra amount of water because the whole thing is between these three states. There is a dispute between Haryana and Punjab also.
Yeah.
So Punjab government could temporarily give water to Delhi. So, and Punjab government, I mean, politically I'm saying, there'll be no problem with them. There should be no problem with them. But anyway, the issue here is not Punjab. Issue here is Haryana and Delhi. And the certain amount of water has to be released by Haryana as per the Supreme Court order of 1996. And if that amount of water is not released,
okay,
even for a single day or maybe 1 or 2 days, the Delhi government would be quite justified in moving the Supreme Court and bringing it to their notice.
So, Dr. Dharinder Tayal, on behalf of the BJP, can you assure the viewers from Delhi who are watching at this point that the Haryana government has not brought down the levels of water supply? Because the fact is the water levels have come down in the Yamuna River. That is not something that is up for debate.
No, so exactly. This is what I also said. In fact, I gave the exact figure. What is committed is 1049 Q6 that Haryana is supposed to give. And it is duty bound and it is bound by the Supreme Court orders. So now look at the clever functioning, which is exactly what Mr. Sehgal has brought forth. What is clever here is you are saying the level has gone down. You're giving us the levels. You are not telling us how much water has come. I mean, it would be equally easy to say, okay, you were supposed to give 1049 Q6, but you are giving only 1000 Q6. But that is not being said. What is being said is where the responsibility lies on you yourself. So that is where it is actually two bits too smart. Now, the other point which Mr. Kaushik raised, which is very interesting, I think, wo bilkul bhi taiyari karke nahi aaye hain. Unhone apni Aatishi ki hi statement nahi suni. I am not the one who's talking about Swati Maliwal. Aatishi has spoken about Swati Maliwal, that BJP is doing everything, including Swati Maliwal. So she has said it. So he should be aware.
Okay. Dr. Tayal, and I'm sorry, I'll have to cut you short. We had to curtail this debate prior because of the developments coming in from Maharashtra at this point. I'll tell you this point. The reason why the citizen of Delhi is fed up of the politics between BJP and Aam Aadmi Party is because of incidents like Swati Maliwal and what that's happening at this point. But thank you so much, Dr. Dharinder Tayal, Sanjeev Kaushik and Omesh Sehgal for joining us with your views at this point.